We're over in Runcorn today with a reported transmission and engine malfunction on this DAF CF Euro 6. After some choice words with the OBD socket, we had our communication established with the truck, which means we can jump onto jaltest from Eclipse Diagnostics and work our magic. We can start with our auto VIN identification. We're selecting Euro 6 today, and we're going to perform a main system scan. This will identify our basic systems on the vehicle and highlight any potential ECUs with issues such as PCI, which is our engine ECU, EAS, which is our after treatment ECU, and gearbox, which in this case, this truck will be Airstronic. With our main systems identified, we can now look at the faults highlighted in red. So we have a big long list here relating to boost pressure, air temperature sensors, coolant temperature, engine protection, injection rail pressure, you name it, we have a high or low voltage issue with it. But what we can see from this particular code, P0699, is that the PCI ECU contains shared 5-volt power supplies. Each of the 5-volt power supply circuits feeds a group of sensors through the PCI ECU. A short to earth or a short to supply on one of these components will also result in DTCs related to the other components connected to this particular group, hence the potential issues with all these components. As you can see here, we've got 24 volts in from the truck to the ECU through fuses E488, E701 and E350. But then when we look at our sensor wiring from the ECU, we have 5 volts out to the sensors. Now this truck's been to two different garages, and even though they've replaced sensors on the engine, they've still not fixed the issue. The customer is reluctant to spend any more money on parts, so I need to come up with some solid evidence to back up my theory of what component is at fault. So my question to you guys is, what do you think it's going to be? Someone's changed the boost pressure sensor. Is it this? Oh dear. I'll just throw that socket on the floor. We'll lift this off and just throw it towards the back here. Thank you. So someone's broke this. Well, if it isn't my old friend, Mr. E-Fan. Why no one hasn't physically checked over this wiring is beyond me. So now we have a potential issue here, we can unplug the E-Fan and see if removing this component from our list makes a difference to our fault codes. Back on jaltest, we can confirm our diagnostics and report this to the customer, as all the faults have now gone from active to inactive. Right, so them faults have gone off now, so it needs a new fan. We've got the fan hub to change today. Got to take this cowling off here, which splits in half, undo the fan, slide that into the fan cowling, and then we can get to the bolts on the fan hub and get that out the bottom. Yay. Now these either come out or they don't. Let's see. And it's a no. Can we get this one? Oh, why did they put this pipe here? So, one didn't break, one did break. But this can now come to pieces. So I've just put the two halves of the fan cowling inside the other part of the fan cowling for now. So all I'm doing now is cracking these bolts off on the fan, which are on the inside, like so.
and then I'll get a gun in later and undo them quicker. So I'll slip this in here and then go for the bolts. As you can see, I've got ample room for the back of the gun so it doesn't interfere with the radiator. And that's that. I'll just keep going around them now. Two. Four. There. Six. Six bolts. Fans loose, yeah? Just got the wiring to undo here. So there's a P-clip at the top. I'm gonna bring this fan this way first to get them pieces out. So, I'll get rid of these for now. Be gone, and you. Be gone. Now I'm gonna pass the fan back through the fan hub. So I've gotta go in, up, and that way. So, fan's on the hub, gotta get it lined up. Like so, turn it, and then I can come through the other side. So now we can work on this ring of bolts here on the crankshaft pulley. It won't be tight, should just be able to do it with a normal spanner. See, nothing mega. So we'll undo these, go round the other side, and undo the other ones, I think. So we've got three to do round this side now. This is a push down, not pull up job now. Oh, throw my spanner on the floor. I'm not going to do it with my ratchet spanner because we all know what happens with ratchet spanners when things are tight. They break. Oh. So we've got last two now holding these on. Bye bye, fan. Let's find a new one. So this is our non-genuine replacement unit. You can see the differences in the manufacturing here. I think this is a Burr unit. Even here you can tell how much difference there is in manufacturing quality. Oh, 3G, what have you done to me? This is gonna work for a week. So rather than me fighting gravity and trying to lift it up, I'm gonna try and slip it through this side because unlike some of the other trucks, the engine seems to be mounted differently to the radiator, etc. So I'm going to try and come through the side on this one, if it'll fit. But I don't know if it will. It might do. We'll give it a go. Got to find where this dowel goes first. Let's orientate this to suit the cutout in the crankshaft pulley, which is there. So I'm going to try and go in this way to it now, hopefully. So it's fitted through here. I've just got to manipulate it into the fan and then onto the fan pulley. Oh God, this weighs a ton. So after much wiggling, we're here now. Except my dowel's got to be on the other side and this has got to come up a bit more, so let's keep wiggling. So I've got half a stud sticking out there. I've just slapped a nut on here to stop it jumping off. Hopefully this will draw it up slightly. And we can try and get this on square then. Right, we'll work on it from this side now. Try and get this square with the pulley. I've just managed to drag the pulley square. Now I'm going to put another nut on this side and then I can draw it up square. Right, let's torque these to spec. That's one torqued. It's another torqued. Let's torque these other ones. We'll do the other side. Right. That's all them tight. Change your gloves time, drink time, put the fan back on time. So we're going to pass this from the front of the fan hub to the rear to get these two halves of the cowling back in now. So we'll get this somewhere near. So we'll give it a twist and we'll come to the other side. Now I can work on the front. Where are them bits? Now, remember me going on about them bolts before and how they go in here. See there, that one come out. If we look at the other end, it snapped off. Luckily, we don't have to use this hole. We'll just use this one. We'll just throw these in here now, out the way. Come on, put you in there. Throw the other one in. There we go. Right, new bolts, new bolts, new bolts. One, two. Yeah, that's tight. Next one. Tight. Next one. So all the bolts in the fan are tight now. This is all secured. Just got to get these halves together now and clipped back in round here. This is probably the most difficult part of the job. Let's feed this one round. So now I've got to make sure they both click together around the fan. Not forget the P-clip. Everybody loves a wire flapping around when the fan's going around. We'll have a look now. We'll see how we get on. We'll see if there's any magical lights on the dash now.
Yeah, once the air's up, should be right off.
Nothing.
Good, absolutely brilliant.
We'll just.
Yeah, because even sometimes you used to get that little EMS there.
Yeah, yeah. So we'll just build the air up and I'd say you're good to go back on the road with this, mate.
No, absolute star, thanks for that.
It's alright. Right.
Makes me feel better.
So there we have it. We have identified our fault through jal test. We've visually identified a possible cause for concern with the wire into the electric fan harness. We've then unplugged the component from our list of possible components as suggested by jal test. After refreshing our fault codes, all the faults were inactive, which gave me enough evidence to safely say to the customer, we need to spend your money on a new fan. It was an hour for diagnostics and an hour and a half to replace the fan. The biggest expense here was the fan at just over £500. As always, hit the like button as it lets me know you thought it was a good video and you want more videos from me. Drop a comment if you've been caught out by the old fan wiring before. Subscribe if you want to be notified of future crap from me. And as always, I'll catch you in the next one.